Howdy, hello, and welcome everybody back to Video with Games with Hollow Knight. In the last episode, I wandered around aimlessly. However, off screen, looking around, I found two things. One is a sign that had a picture of... That is number two, by the way. I figured out how to use these things. One was a sign from very early in the game that has the same icon as, like, the city pointing signs I've been seeing down here. And it says to, like, go through, like, the green and the fungal stuff in order to get to, like, the city beneath the city. And I am pretty damn sure we gotta go this way. But importantly, number two that I've already demonstrated, I figured out how to use these things right here, the bouncy pads. You have to attack them, which doesn't seem super intuitive to me. I'm not, like, whenever you encounter something like that in a game otherwise, usually you would either, like, hit the jump button when you jump off of it, and that would boost you a little bit higher, or maybe you get, like, ground pound, and you put more force into it for you to bounce back up higher. Not the case this time around. But that's okay, because the secrets have been revealed. That is probably the direction I need to go, which means we actually have to go back up and around to the top area of this place. Which is okay. It is okay, because just actually knowing what to do now feels really, really, really good and makes me genuinely happy. So let's get on our merry freaking way. So while we are on our way, in episode 6, I believe, I started to talk about Zelda, the Breath of the Wild. And I sort of stopped because I was too busy trying to navigate and failing terribly. But I wouldn't mind talking about it some more, because it's pretty dang cool. And I also have no idea if the Switch has HDCP protection. There's a little inside baseball here. But the Elgato capture device that I have will not capture... It won't capture video if the video output is HDCP protected. Also, I don't know if there's, like, an end to this room or if it's just, like, an infinite looping. I'm just gonna take a look while I'm talking, to be honest. So yeah, I don't know if I can make a video on Breath of the Wild, even if I wanted to. And I'm not sure that I want to, and it's... That game... Hot damn, is that game... really big. You ever, like, how is it that I mentioned it before, but, like, both Horizon and Breath of the Wild come out 3 days apart and both of them are fucking massive. Like, if you've seen gameplay footage from, like, E3 and Breath of the Wild, chances are good you've seen footage of the just the starting area, the Great Plateau, as it were. And that starting area is not a significantly large portion of the entire map. You freaking, like, after getting the tablet and the map function in that game, and looking at, like, after I left the plateau, I just, like, zoomed out on the map, and I was like, oh, my universe has expanded. I can feel it. I can feel the cosmos. That game is big. Games are big. You know, there's too many fucking video games. This is a problem that I've encountered. Apparently. There are just actually too many video games now. We need to delete some. Just contact these companies, get them to drag these games over to the recycle bin and save them for later, at best. Got too many. Of course, is just joking. Why did I not attack them? Why did I not attack the man? The puff man. Okay. Go down? Yes, good. But it is a very good time to be a person who enjoys video games. Absolutely. You still here? Still talking about napping? Manny or Mildred? Yes, okay. Enjoy your nap. Apologies for the disruption. Oh, I broke it. Can I get to there from that one? Absolutely. I like that the money rock. I don't know what the fuck Geo is. Besides being a currency, I don't know what it actually is, like, lore-wise, if there is lore for the Geo. But I like that the Geo sources in this area are mushrooms instead of just rocks. That's cool. I like it. Oh, new fucking location though. Can you believe it? Ooh, shortcut. My fucking favorite. I mentioned that I was considering playing... Oh, it's right to the beginning. I mentioned that I was considering doing a series on Bloodborne, and I am. And just, like, that... Fuck... Bloodborne, man. If you've heard the phrase shortcut porn being used in relation to Bloodborne, it is an accurate description. That game has some dope-ass shortcuts. I don't know if they're... Oh, hey, it's Hornet. Hi, Hornet. Pardon me a moment. I'm gonna check over here. Okay, not. We're gonna check. Hornet, what's up? No, come back, please. Hornet. People talk about Dark Souls 1 being, like, really interwoven. Ooh. Here ends the Pilgrim's Way. Hollowness's heart lays open before you. Proceed onward to share in its glory. Oh, no. I can't proceed onward to share in its glory. It's too much ass in the way. Too much ass in the way. All right, down here we go. Yeah, Dark Souls 1. In fact, one of the reasons why, like, people love Dark Souls 1 more than, like, Dark Souls 2 or 3 is just the interconnectivity of the world and how that shit... I need to not attack that, like, for real. How everything in that game, like, fits together, it's actually just kind of incredible. Dark Souls 1 is, like, many concentric rings... like, stacked on top of each other and, like, within one another. Whereas Dark Souls 2 is more like a star. Like, a star with, like, several points to it. And Dark Souls 3 is, like, a tree. With multiple branches, but, like, one main branch that goes throughout the whole thing. Being the true path. Fuck. So happy to find, like, the progression. I wanted it so long. So bad for so long. The noise they make is delightful. Oh, here we go. Oh god! Ah. Caterpillar! My friend! God, they're the best. Those caterpillars are, like, one of the best parts about the game. I'm not even gonna front with you. I love them so much. So, Hell Hunter, why are you talking about Dark Souls and Zelda in this Hollow Knight world that we're in? I don't know. The thing about Metroidvanias is there's a whole lot of wandering around and going from one place to another. Just to, like, try to find where you might possibly have to go, because goddamn. And I swear to God, if you tell me that this isn't progression, and that I... Okay, gotta go back. We're gonna have a fucking problem. We found the end to the Pilgrim's Way, and that is where we have to go for sure. But we gotta find where to go now. To get whatever we need it to get across that gap. We need a pa- You know what? I think I know what it is. I think I might know what it is. And I made a joke about it. Masks or, like, skulls? I'm not sure. I made a joke about it earlier on in the series about potentially get- oh god! About potentially getting like a shine spark. That was a joke. But I think we might get a shine spark. Mantis warrior. Member of a proud tribe, fiercely protective of its territory, launches savage attacks with bladed forelimbs. I'm so fucking happy to have found the progression. You don't understand. Flying mantis? What? Mantis youth. Member launches sting attacks with its needle-sharp abdomen. Please give me a shine spark. I would be so happy. You have no idea. You have no understanding of how happy getting a shine spark would make me in this game. Just more movement options in general, but for real. Also, keep an eye on that health. A little bit, just a little bit. Maybe fewer Hadoukens and more Estus chugging. Come on. You gotta activate your Hamon breathing to heal your body. Wanderers seeking death, welcome. May you find swift end upon our claws. Mantises seem like they could be maybe a little friendlier. They could do with a little friendly, I think. I want more powers. I want to see what powers this game gives me, because I feel very lacking in powers. Can I even dodge that shit? I actually don't know. Almost definitely yes. I'm gonna go with almost definitely yes. I'm not one to often blame... Yeah, there we go. Maybe not in like a narrow space, but I'm not one to blame a video game for my own feelings if I can help it. Sometimes some bullshit just does actually happen and you gotta just recognize that and move on with your life. Down bench. Can I trust it? Sure as shit hope so. Where is this down bench? I guess I'm just gonna sprint to this bench, wherever it could be. There it is. Thank Christ. Where are we? Alright, I missed a way to the left, all the way back up there. I think I'll probably take a view... Take a peek. Up there, before I move on. Those mushrooms, now that I know how to use them, just really, really nice, really satisfying. Boing. Feels good, just feels good. Oh, yeah. Oh no. give me your best Hamon breathing. I'll wait. I don't think mine is particularly good. And I don't know, my throat's feeling a little too right now anyway, but that's okay. There are a lot of masks or heads? It's hard to tell. Maybe both. Like, stop for a second just to explain myself. If you look at, what's his name? Coral. Coral has, like, a helmet, I think, that looks like a mask. It looks like a head, sort of. I don't know if it's actually a mask or if it's like a skull that he took off someone or something. I don't know, man. He's a mysterious character. But, like, the point being is like, what actually is going on? What is this stuff? And don't die, also. I was trying to kill him before I needed to use a Hadouken. Because I really want to use this to heal and not to projectile. There we go. There's a lever I cannot reach. That is unfortunate. Where are we? I don't know, because I haven't rested a bench. So, I've been thinking... I promise. I've been thinking about my opinions on this game a bit more than it's really pretty and it feels punchy, etc., etc. And I've come to the conclusion that I'm not sure how I really feel. I've come to a conclusion that I haven't come to a conclusion on how I feel about the map in particular. Because, like, as I said, I believe last episode, navigation is sort of a really important thing in Metroidvanias. And to have your navigation ability be so restricted in terms of needing to buy maps, like, aimlessly explore an area to find Cornifer to buy a map. Does this say another badge? Take the Mantis Claw. Oh my god, they gave me the wall jump. They just fucking gave me the keys to the kingdom. Oh my god. Oh, that's a good feeling wall jump. Never mind, I'm in love again. Oh, we've done it. We've reached the pinnacle of humanity. So what, to boil it all down, I'm not sure that I like, per se, having to use Cornifer to get a map at all of an area. And also, while you're exploring it, you can't add to your map until you find a bench, and benches are moderately rare. Have I been up here? I have not. What the fuck is this? No, for real though, what the fuck is that? It does not seem responsive. I don't really know, okay. What's this? What's this? What's this? Wanderer's Journal. Is it? It's not this part of the journal, is it? Charms inventory. Map in Quill City Crest. Oh. Wanderer's Journal. A journal left behind by a long dead traveler. The words are written in a forgotten dialogue and difficult to understand. Relic from Hellenus' past. This item now holds little value except for those dedicated to the history of the kingdom. I see. So more of a, like a side quest item than a lore dump, sadly. I have so many questions about this world, and I don't even know where to begin to ask them. And remember that time that I said I was gonna boil down what I was trying to say and then fucking rambled more and didn't finish my sentence? I do. Basically, Metroidvanias, I like adding to a map. I like being able to navigate via map without having to, like, reach a certain point and save and have that be it. All in all, I think I'm not super fond of the map system. That's all. Okay. Now let's see what's up here. I mean, it makes it satisfying to find benches even more than it already is. But, wait, no! Damn it. Try to open my map and freaking bomb you. Found me first. Oh, we're just here, okay. Right, yeah, couldn't get up there. Bit of a shortcut, I guess? God, I need to make something very clear right this second. And it is that the wall jumping feels great. Feels tight and responsive for the most part. when you're not bad at it, like I am. It just does feel good though. Oh fuck. Unless you're bad at it, like I am. Okay. I like the idea behind this though. Yeah. See, that's what I'm talking about. Combining your abilities to make cool jumps and shit like that. That's what I'm about. That's my fucking jam in these games. And again, it's like a tight movement system in a game like this. Even as much as I inherently love Metroidvanias, what did that do? Was that just a really dramatic door opening? I don't know. I wish I knew. I can't check the map though. See what I'm saying? Did that open something else somewhere else? Oh, okay, that looks like probably the source of that noise. Just give me a bench, I guess. Just give me a bench and I can view the map again. The reason why I like Zero Mission more than Super Metroid in terms of, like, gameplay is the tight-ass movement. It's what I crave. It's what I desire. A lot of switches, like, almost unnecessary amount of switches. If only Nintendo could follow suit. For real though, apparently, well, I mean, what am I fucking talking about? This is literally the day after the Switch came out that I'm recording this. So maybe they restock them real quick. Maybe not. Probably not. But maybe, oh. But maybe, you know? But maybe. I actually thought that part of the foreground was a wall. I was mistaken. Luckily, too, because it means I can go forward. Oop. I'm so happy I have a wall jump. I'm so fucking happy. Oh my god. I can't wait. I can't wait to see what else they give me. This has... Instead of satiating my thirst for movement options, it merely strengthened it. Is there any way over here that I missed? I believe, yes. This looks like, you guys, your heads look like Hornet. Are you related? Challenge? Mantis Lords. Oh god, I'm gonna die. Yeah, turns out, dashing into him, maybe not the best idea. Oh, fuck. If only there was a bench. If only there was a bench closer. Luckily, the map should update now that I'm back, yeah. So what do we got? What do we got? There was an exit on the right side that I missed. There was a door upwards that I think I missed. Is Hornet... This is gonna be a funny question. Is Hornet a mantis? I don't know, actually. Hi. You okay? You alright over there? Hell Hunter, you say. Maybe you should go back and get your ghost before you start exploring new areas. Yeah, well... You're right, also, but... I don't know. Well, I'm here, right? As a door. Unbreakable. Oh my god, what's this? What's this? What's this? Dash Master? What could that be? Hey. Also, that looks like Sans in badge form. Bears the likeness of an eccentric bug known only as the Dash Master. The bear will be able to dash more often as well as dash downwards. What? Yeah! Holy shit, yes! You see what I'm talking- Oh, secret. See what I'm talking about? Oh, go get your ghosts, you say. Fight me. Bet you won't. Is there any- Yes, wall jumping. I was gonna say, is there any point to this outside of... the enemies, but I have new abilities. Turns out, I actually came here in the proper order. Go figure. No. Damn it. It's okay, it's dead. God, it feels so good when it receives your input. Which is coincidentally my go-to dirty talk in the bedroom. The dashes are so good. Hopefully you don't need the badge. I feel like it would be really kind of annoying to make the, I appreciate that it puts you right back there, by the way. I feel like it'd be really annoying to make the, this section requiring, that's the word I'm looking for. Requiring the badge that you just got, making you have to go all the way back to the bench. Hi. Oh, please don't leave me behind. You forgot about me? I knew you would. Everyone always forgets about me. Oh, who are you? Okay? Were you going hollow? Your face, you're so. Preda. I'm sorry, I got lost. I don't know how I ended up here. You came here to rescue me. Right? You came here to rescue me, Preda? The girl that everyone just ignores? Sure. Sorry, when I look at your face, I just can't believe you came all the way down here to rescue me. I didn't think anybody... Sorry, I mean, thank you. I mean, I'd better go. Back to town, I mean. I'd better get home. Are you gonna go by yourself? Thank you. Thank you, I guess. Thank you for a nice, fun little, wall jump challenge. Hell yeah, give me that sweet, sweet wall jump badge. Or, dash badge. Yeah. Oh, that's good. And I can dash down now, which makes me wonder if that's how, if that's like the ground pound sort of thing I've been looking for. I am unsure. Okay, I can only still dash once in the air. That has not changed. Fuck. Dashing down also hilariously does not let you bounce off those any higher, but what are you gonna do? Where's that exit? It should be like right here. Up there, I guess? Get the flip out of here. You're my way. Yeah, I don't think you dodged this one. Just straight up. Also definitely should have healed there, but such is life. Yeah, there's like an exit on this wall that I'm not finding. It might be hidden. Try to find it. I wanna know. Can you show me? Wanna know about the hidden exits? No? I guess not. Okay. Weird. Pretty weird. Alright, let's go back to the mantis. Oh, God! It's not enough soul to heal? Come on. Oh, Coral, what's up, man? Hello again. I suppose you've already met the tribe of this village, hmm? They seem a little distrustful of strangers, to put it lightly. They're not brutes, though, no. The sickness in the air that clouds the mind of lesser beasts, they resist it. They retain their intellect and their honor, although also their lethal traditions. I have some words of advice, my friend. If you plan to challenge the lords of this tribe, your blunted nail may prove inadequate. There's a city nearby, the old capital of Hallownest. I've heard a nailsmith resides there. Seek the old bug out, and you may progress that much easier. May find progress that much easier. Thank you, my friend, but I do not yet have the... as far as I can tell, the means to get in there. Also, I don't think it puts your ghost in the boss room. But it might put your ghost in the boss room. Maybe not. So there's an exit to the right that I missed? I totally missed that lever. However you get there. Fuck. No. What's up? Please, bench. For the love of God, if there is... Do you... No. No, why do you do this? Why? Why? You son of a bitch! And it remains closed. This fucking guy right here. This fucking guy. That is obscene. Well, I mean, if I just straight up die, I won't need to worry about my... Okay. That was going to be a joke. This, I promise. Because now I have to go... Well, it's not as far, I guess. I still have to get the soul vessel fixed by getting my ghost. But looking at the time, that is the perfect time to end this episode. So thank you very much for watching. I am so fucking happy that I not only found where to go, but also found some fucking movement tech upgrades. It really, like, just relighted my excitement for this game. The last, like, two episodes, you can probably tell in the commentary, wasn't really feeling it because I was getting really tired of being lost and not sure of where to go. But just finding where to go and finding an upgrade, just even one, has relit that spark. And I'm excited to play some more. So, once again, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you on the next episode of Video with Games with Hollow Knight. Toodles!